Now let's talk a bit about mobile app marketing in this module. Now when I say mobile app, I mean a native app. That's what I'm referring to, like an iPhone app that would be downloaded from Apple's App Store, or on the Android side, an Android app that's downloaded from the Google Play Store, or it could be an iPad app from Apple's App Store. It's not a web-based site that's optimized for mobile screens. So that's not what we're talking about here with mobile apps, because pretty much everything we've covered up until this point and everything we will cover in this course, it doesn't matter so much whether it's a desktop screen or a smartphone looking at a web page. Those are the same sites that can be optimized to work with both. And the marketing is pretty much the same there. There are, of course, differences in conversion rates and how things perform based on what kind of device someone uses. But a web-based world and a native app world are completely different. In this module, we're talking about native apps. So a quick overview and a quick thing to point out right away is, if you check out the extra section in this portal, down the left-hand side towards the bottom, look at the extra section, you'll see that there's a bonus course that was put in there called App Business Academy. Now, this is a class I taught a few years ago that was like $2,500. It was a pretty premium, expensive class. And it was all about how to start your own app business, or you know, how to generate money from apps themselves. So outside of any other types of marketing, how to build a business just with apps. Now, it was produced a few years ago, so some of the content and information has changed. The market has changed. Apps and that whole mobile app world has become a lot more competitive. So there are some things that aren't as easy as they used to be. But the majority of that content is still evergreen. It still applies today. If you want to know anything about mobile apps and kind of looking at competitors and seeing what they're doing, and you know, how to hire someone to make a custom coded app for you, and a lot of other things just to do with the business in general, how to outsource, how to manage that, you know, how to budget for that. So if you want to know all about mobile apps, check out that course, because there's over 10 hours of lessons just about mobile apps. So we're not going to go that deep in this module here, because we have so many hours already that we're covering in this Traffic Secrets course. But the basics of traffic, you can get a lot of traffic from mobile apps if, of course, you have a mobile app that can get discovered. And I'll talk about some secrets to kind of how to get ranked in the App Store and everything else. But you have to know that you're not going to create a mobile app, put it on Apple's App Store, and get a million downloads and start getting all this traffic, building a huge opt-in list, and then, of course, making all this money for your business with a mobile app. It doesn't work that way, and it's not that easy. The app business and world itself has become so competitive. I mean, you see now TV commercials promoting games, you know, mobile games, iPhone games usually. And that's because the demand and need for these companies to get people to install their apps is sky high. Because many of these giant production companies that make these video games, they have these, you know, you've probably seen them or even used them. They have, you know, these elaborate in-app purchase schemes where somebody gets the free game, you know, it's called the freemium model. You download the free game, and then only about 5% of people that download it actually spend any money in the game itself, but that's where they make all their money. And they make billions of dollars with a B. There's billions being made now with iPhone games. It's a huge industry. And because of all that money at stake for these game makers to get people to install their games, they dominate ad networks for buying installs and for things like that. And in a way, they've ruined the market for everybody else. It's hard to have an app for your business, let's say if you're in the real estate market or, you know, any other market where you can actually, you know, buy installs for your app. And we're going to talk about that and actually advertise to get people to download your app, really to turn that into a profit. Because the cost per app install, it's so high now. It's you know, it's at least about $2 in most marketplaces, most ad networks, but it can really be $3, $4, $5 or more just for an app install. And just getting an app installed doesn't mean the user is going to be using the app or even will ever turn the app on, but the network still charges you if someone just downloads it. And people download apps all the time and they don't even use them. So just being dead honest with you up front, and that's how, of course, I always want to be, and I always want our company to be, and, you know, giving you any kind of information about generating traffic for your business and helping you make the right decisions. Because first of all, there's, as we've been talking about, there's no shortage of places for you to drive traffic for your business. What it comes down to is how cost effectively you can do it and how you can turn it into a profit. And the mobile app world, why it's important for us to cover it in our curriculum, and it does have some good opportunities for traffic, and it does have the potential for you to reach a broad new audience, and sometimes for free, I would be doing you a disservice if I didn't give it to you straight and tell you the honest truth about the industry. You know, several years ago, I went and built a mobile video game business, and we also had a secondary sister company that did general apps as well, like information apps. And that's what that App Business Academy course was based on a few years ago. It was my success that I had with that business. And so I was teaching other people basically how to do what we had done in that business. But over the years, especially since that course was produced and since I was in that business, I'm no longer in that business. The market has gotten so competitive. Like I said, those game companies have driven up the app installs. So it's hard to even invest money into growing an app-based business or a single app, just because you can't. It's hard to scale it. You can't, even if you had an app that made money from people downloading it. It's very hard to reinvest in it to turn a profit, and really to grow it with more and more app downloads. It's a very, very tough business. So I'm just being very honest and upfront with you about the mobile app world itself, because I have so much experience with it. I mean, we created a bunch of titles, but we had one game that we created. It was a horse racing game that had in-app purchases. And in a very short period of time, I grew it from nothing to over $1 million in revenue. It was a free game from people buying the in-app purchases, the same model that's driving the whole game industry, these freemium models. And so while that's a pretty decent accomplishment of generating $1 million in revenue from one app, we couldn't scale it. We couldn't reinvest in the business. The game luckily was ranked high in the App Store. And if you can get apps to rank high in the App Store, if you can find especially like low-hanging fruit, there's not a lot of competition. Because people are finding apps by doing searches in app stores. That's where they're discovering apps. They search for stuff. So they look up keywords. So again, if you can add apps that are kind of ranked for not non-competitive keywords or not as competitive keywords, then you can get tons of free downloads. And if you had a bunch of apps titled with, you know, and we'll talk about App Store SEO, but if you had a bunch of apps for your business and they were, you know, had different titles targeted to different keywords, and you did some different things, you could potentially get a bunch of free downloads, even thousands of downloads a month. So it is very possible. However, the app industry itself, like I said, and the point I wanted to finish on, was that it's just gotten so saturated, and it's just something that you shouldn't put too many of your resources into, is what I would say. At least right now, the state of how things are. Only because, like I said, even if you had an app that was able to turn into money for your business, it's very hard to scale it. You're better off spending your resources on the desktop kind of web-based world stuff, you know, AdWords, Facebook ads, content marketing with SEO, and building an affiliate program or doing joint ventures, you know, even podcasts, exploring all those other areas rather than trying to get people to download your mobile app once you have an app. And you should have an app. Again, it depends on your business. If you're a personality or an expert or author, you should definitely have an app. It's great for branding. I'm going to talk about that a bit in this module. Anyways, if you want to learn the ins and outs of kind of the app world and the app business world, there's over 10 hours of lessons in that extra section, in that bonus course that I've added to the learning portal here. So you can check that out when you get some time. But that goes a lot deeper, of course, than what this module, how it's going to go into app stuff. But anyways, just wanted to mention that. So mobile apps, like I've already said, they can generate some opt-ins, they can generate some website traffic. So you can get some downloads, you can get some of that traffic and that activity, which is what we're talking about in the first place. But there are some things that you need to know, and I'm going to be pointing out some important things. And like I just mentioned a minute ago, if you're an author or personality or depending on your business, apps are great for branding and authority. Just to even say you have an app, check out our iPhone app. Like, that just kind of makes you seem more important. We're going to talk about that. I mentioned this. It's so important for me to say this up front. Again, I don't ever want to mislead you. I don't want to teach you about different ways to get app installs, different way to advertise, and then just leave you with the old caveat of, well, it's just something that you need to test for your business. I'm going to tell you right now up front, don't waste any of your hard-earned money trying to buy advertising for your mobile app. Most people probably would never tell you that. I'm going to tell you that. Again, unless you've exhausted all the other traffic areas for your business, which you probably never will, I think the expenditure into an investment into mobile app installs and traffic just has such a bad ROI. I mean, I've already been there. I've spent thousands and thousands of dollars, and it's only getting worse every day. And so I know the whole app install game, and yeah, there could be exceptions in small country markets or certain language areas where you could get installs a lot cheaper. But I've bought thousands of installs back when there wasn't as much competition. I've bought them for 10 cents a piece, and I couldn't turn a profit. And now they're like $2 a piece on average or more. And there's almost no app that will turn that into a positive ROI. Because it just won't. I mean, like I said, people install an app, they don't even run it. You know, they're not going to just instantly go buy your products from the app. It's very, very rare. You can build opt-ins from the app, but it's going to take you several people installing your app before you get an install. Before you get an opt-in. So the cost per opt-in, if you're buying the app installs and advertising, for what the cost is for opt-in driven from, you know, AdWords, Facebook, any other platform where you'd spend money, it's just on mobile, for mobile native apps, it's just way more expensive. You know, you could realistically, you can build leads all day long in most markets for $4 or $5 after you draw, or even a little bit less after you draw the traffic. App installs, you may spend $50 before you get someone to not only install, but to opt into your list. That's actually going to be a decent lead. So I just want to point that out up front, just full transparency about mobile apps. I have a tremendous amount of experience in this market. And I suggest that you don't spend any money trying to promote your app. There are some exceptions, like doing a charting campaign, but it takes quite a bit of money. I'm going to get to that when I talk about buying installs, because I will cover buying installs just because it's part of the process, but it's going to be up to you whether you do it or not. But for most people, for most of our students, most of our customers, 95% plus, I would highly recommend that you just don't spend any money at all. Now, doesn't mean you don't want to dabble in mobile apps and create some basic mobile apps or do some mobile app things and try to get them ranked, try to get some free downloads, which can create some free opt-ins and ultimately hopefully can create some free customers for you. Can definitely create your mobile app distribution for doing push notifications and things like that to drive them. When we talk about traffic recycling, like to our social media posts and things to drive more likes and shares and to get a little bit of that viral marketing, as well as to drive them towards, you know, videos and all kinds of other things, to get the benefit of that as well, that can then create more traffic, turning that, you know, one visitor into 2, 3, 4, 5. But anyways, the mobile app world is very interesting, but don't believe the hype as far as that it's just this magical thing that if you had an app for your business, it's going to make you all this money. Because it's not the case. There are always exceptions. And like I said, you could stumble upon with proper research some areas where you can get plenty of organic traffic, free downloads every day just from being in the app store and not spending any money. And that's where I would want you to focus. But again, don't go wasting a bunch of money on app installs, because you're going to see that option for app installs on, when you set up campaigns everywhere now, Facebook, AdWords, et cetera.